Hey guys, it's me Charlie. On this video, what I'm going to be doing is weighing some button quails. I want to weigh the difference between the male and the female. And here I have a little scale, and this is a really good, inexpensive, cheap scale. It was about $9.99, and it's to weigh any type of dough or flour or sugar or coffee or anything you're weighing. So what I decided to do with this here is I decided to use this as my way of weighing babies and eggs and button quails. And I just got through weighing some Coturnix quails, the Italian golden Coturnix, and both of them weighed at 8 ounces, which is right there. Each one weighed 8 ounces. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take this little plastic container off, and I'm going to use this to weigh my babies. And what I got to do is I got to put this on top. And I have already turned the dial to make this zero, because anything that weighs too much or not very much, it's going to be off a little bit. You're going to see this line be over here if it's really light, or over here if it's really heavy. So I've already set it. And so what I'm going to do is I'm going to put in a male button quail, and we're going to weigh him to see what he weighs, and I'll show you that next. So this is my male button quail, and the way I can tell is my males, they tend to have all their feathers because they're not the ones that are being attacked by other males for mating. It's always the females that are slightly bald. But if you have a large enough cage, that doesn't usually happen. You can have females that look like this with all her feathers. The other way I can tell is I've actually banded all my females on her leg. Let's see if we can see it. See, it's pink. That is a female. And on this little guy, his is blue. I hope you guys can see that in this video. And so what I'm going to do next is I'm going to take this little carrier, a small little carrier. It's already been weighed, so that way it'll be zeroed out. And I placed it right on top. And this little guy weighs almost 2 ounces. So, gosh, I wish this could pick that up. There we go. So yeah, he's about 2 ounces. Let's just say he's 2 ounces. So I'm going to now weigh the female. Ew, he pooped. Sicko. I know. I'm not picking it up. Oh, do you guys want to hear him make his little sounds? He was just about to do it. Well, I guess not. Maybe we'll catch it a little bit later. Alright, so I got my male back into another little cage carrier here. These guys are just so wild acting. You have to be really careful with them, because you see the width from here all the way up here? This is about 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, I guess 6 inches high. And with 6 inches height, these guys go pow and smack the side of their heads, or the top of their heads, kind of like this female just did. And if they do it too hard, if it's too high up, they will actually cut their heads, and you'll see blood on the top of their heads, which really sucks. And matter of fact, I think, no, she's good. All right, so this is the female, and she's bigger, and she actually has, I believe, an egg in her. See how she banged her head on top? So it's better to have less height when you're transferring little button quails. And then be very careful when you open this up, because these guys could fly like 50 feet straight up. All right, so let's go back to weighing. So this is the girl. I don't know if you could see her band right there. And we're going to go ahead and put her on top of here. And she weighs, oh gosh, don't. She also weighs 2 ounces, but you know, the other male was about 1 ounce and almost 1.5 ounces, and she's 2 ounces. Even though I said 2 ounces on the male, but I was just rounding it up. So with her, she's about 2 ounces. She's a little bit bigger. So that's the difference in the male and females when they're adults. One weighs more than the other, which is the females. And of course the little guys, they growl and they make loud peeping sounds. So be really careful with your button quails, because they like to freak out and bump their heads on top. So, alright, so if you guys have any questions or comments, don't forget to subscribe. And I'll see you guys on the next video. That light's from my incubator. I have some baby button quails that hatched. Some pieds, vaders, and one are tuxedo pieds and silver vaders. A cinnamon red-breasted and a pied. Hi, little girl. Just wanted to add something real quick. This is my Italian golden Coturnix, and she's actually getting her feathers back on the back side because the button quills were trying to mate with her, and she had like lots of missing feathers. So now they're growing back, but she is kind of a frizzled type Italian Coturnix. She's been like this since she was a baby chick, and it's the older she gets and the more she molts, the more she turns that curly feathers. And of course that's just guarding her because she just loves the quails. So I wanted to show you here, I put this plastic container back on, which she doesn't mind me weighing her that way. She's actually kind of calm. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to zero this out. And what I do is I turn it to the back. I got this little round knob here. And you turn it until you can get it to go to zero. And zero. All right. So now I'm going to put her in there. So let's grab her. And she tends to do okay in here. I hope she doesn't jump out. So there she goes. She weighs 8 ounces, 9. She's actually 10 ounces. The reason why she's 10 ounces is because she's got an egg in her. So once she lays this egg, I don't know how many ounces a quail egg is. It's probably an ounce. She's probably 8, 9 ounces. She's a 9 ounce button quail probably. I'll weigh her after she lays the egg, and I probably will do a video. And I think that's it. So this is Joey, and the reason why her name is Joey is because when she was a little button quail, I was hoping for a little boy, and she acts like a little boy. And as you can see, she's also an Italian golden Coturnix, but her colors are a little bit more leopard looking. She's actually got a lot more black than Jakey does. Now, I don't know if I mentioned Jakey's name because I was doing the video and I haven't really went back to see it, but now Jakey I was hoping was a little boy too, but of course, Jakey ended up laying eggs, so Jakey's a girl. So I have two girl Italian golden Coturnix. This little girl, she does not like to be on top of there. She actually kind of flips out and runs out. She's got all her feathers. See her little tail, her back. She looks really good. This is the new version of Italian Coturnix. This is not the original color, which is that dark colored Coturnix with the black. This is the golden, so don't know if the feathers are showing up. Now she is about 2 months old, I believe. I'm not sure. I think she's about 2 months old. And she's also laying eggs. And since I don't have a male, I may have to order a male because I don't want to incubate any more Coturnix and get more girls because they tend to be more girls than boys. But I'm just going to order a really young male. And I would love the old version of the Italian Coturnix because they have dark heads, like the entire head, all of, let's see if I can put my finger there. Okay, so all of the head right there will be like a chocolate color. And I forgot the name, what they call them. If you guys remember, put a comment below. It starts with a CH, like Tremaine, I don't know, I forgot. So let me just weigh her and see what happens. She's probably not going to let me. So here we go. Put her in there. She flipped out earlier, so there she goes. She's about to jump out. So she's 9. She doesn't have an egg in her, I believe. She's 9 ounces. She did really well. I wonder if she was just freaked out in the bird room. I'm sure she's a fly out in any second now. She's about 9 ounces. Sorry, I pushed the button. She's about 9 ounces. So this is my little girl. I'm going to grab her. She's probably going to flip out. Nope. These two I worked with since they were little. Coturnix grow really quickly. They lay eggs around 6 to 8 weeks. Really? So cute. So they're my favorites. Jakey's my number one favorite, and she's about 6 months old. And then Joey here is my number two favorite. And I'm going to get them a boy. I'm sure he's not going to be very tame. Probably not going to be able to handle him at all, because where he's coming from, they're just going to be hatched out. And they they mail, they ship off juveniles and adults, and they're like, I think $4 or something, but the shipping's like 14. Alright, so I thought I'd do a quickie and show you guys what the Coturnix that I have weigh. And these guys are actually going to be mating with a Tibetan male. And those guys are kind of like Joey here. I'll probably show you guys that on a different video. Alright, see you guys on the next video. Hey guys, it's me, Charlie. So I'm going to do a video on weighing my Tibetan quail. And I have a male and female. The female is on the right and the male is on the left. And I have my little measuring weigher, whatever they call it. And I've already zeroed it out so that way I can use this here. And we're going to see how this works. Now these guys may not cooperate with me because I don't really play with them as much. I did when they were babies. I played with them a lot. But as adults, they're a little crazy. So let's do this one first. Who are you? You look like the boy. Yeah, you're the boy because you have all the feathers in the back. All right, so let's see. Oh, gosh. You probably will not cooperate. Sit still. All right. Nope. You're going to fly out. All right. Hey. Okay, this is not going to work. But you know what? He weighed out at 8 ounces. Oh, gosh. This little boy weighed out at 8 ounces. Now, let's see what the female weighs out. Gosh. Okay, she's worse. All right, let's see what happens. She's at 8, 9, 10 ounces. And she's got some missing feathers. Well, that's what happens when they're not really used to being played with. And of course, my little Duchess is going to bring her over here. Well, maybe not. She went the other way. Duchess, bring over here. So this is the boy. You can hear him call his female. And before my Tibetan female gets killed by one of my 19-year-old cats, she's really tame. She doesn't kill my birds, but, you know, quails are a different story probably. So if anybody has any comments, any questions, don't forget to subscribe. And I'll see you guys in the next video. Thanks for watching. Just wanted to add an update on the difference between my male Coturnix, which is the Tibetan breed. So I knew that was going to happen. Once they get their wings going, they'll flap. So let me just grab by the waist. So the male and the female look just about exactly alike. I noticed that the males have a lot more pretty breast feathers than the female does. And the females are heavier than the males, and the flight feathers on the male is the same. Their whole body is just evenly proportioned in this beautiful colors. So there really isn't a huge difference between the male and the female. But the females lay eggs and the males don't, of course. And when the males use the bathroom, when they're in breeding condition, you'll notice there'll be foam in their feces. And that is just an indication that he is ready for breeding. And he will help make babies. And the females will be nice and plump and weigh more. And this one here on the right side, you'll notice that her feathers aren't as dark and rich and red like his. And they're a little bit more duller. But they look very much alike. If you only had a female, you couldn't tell the difference. Because her plumage looks just like his. Look at her tummy. It looks just like his. And he's right here on this side. And look at him. That was perfect that they switched. So they look very much alike. But I noticed that the back feathers on my female is slightly different than the male's back feathers. He's a lot more prettier. And part of it's because he mates with her and he pulls her feathers. And the other part is probably the males are just more prettier. So, and then see, she's got a few missing feathers on the side of her head from him grabbing her and holding her down. The other thing I've noticed is the eye size on the male is bigger than the eye size on the female. There you go. Gosh, it's like they're listening. So the male on the left and the female on the right, you can see their eye size. Look at that. They did it again. They are slightly different. He's bigger. He's a little bit more prouder, so he stands up tall when he's walking around and prancing. And he also makes a nice continuous little gurgle sounds when he's eating, and it's a way of calling the females over. And these guys lay eggs every single day. As a matter of fact, this female laid me a jumbo size egg, which I believe is a double yolk. She's done it once before, so I wouldn't be surprised if she gave me a double yolk today. And these guys do incubate 2 weeks, and actually about 19 days, I should say. They take a little longer than the button quails do. So these guys will take about 2.5 weeks to incubate. And once they hatch, they are the cutest little babies. They look like they have eye makeup and mascara and eyeliner. They're super, super cute. So I really like the way the babies look. I'm not too crazy about the Tibetans plumage and color. I like the Italian better. For some reason, I was interested in getting the darker one just to have a dark breeding pair. And I like having this male and female only. But I would prefer to get one more female so that way he doesn't mate with her so much and get her bald. But also, if you have a good size enclosure, they will actually mate, and they the female won't have missing feathers as much. But they're in a good size enclosure with button quails, and he mates with her because she's the only one in there. So I'm actually going to put the other two girls that I have, which is the Italian Coturnix, golden Italian Coturnix, with him, so that way he can mate with all three of them, and that way there'll be a variety of babies coming from the three different girls. So I'm really not sure what kind of babies you get by combining the Italian golden Coturnix and the Tibetans, but all of the quails, the Coturnix quails, they all originate from one original breed, and they just made these new colors. And so these come in so many different types. If you guys Google it, you'll see many, many different types of quail. So Coturnix quails, they're all Coturnix. So if anybody has any questions, comments, don't forget to subscribe. I guess I'll see you guys in the next video. This entire time, Kyla has been wanting me to pick her up. Good lordy. It was hard to make this video with her jumping all over me. You're so silly. Silly girl, give me a kiss. Mwah. All right, see you guys in the next video.